All right, thank you for staying with us. It's still sports tonight, and we were discussing the stalemated game, final game of Division 2B in the Nigerian National League between ABS and Gateway. Onye, let me come to you. I wasn't in a lorry, and I don't have the complete picture of what happened.
I was not in a lorry too.
But I know that Gateway didn't play. And that's the story. Gateway didn't play. Who told them not to play? Who argued against who? These are issues that I think the NFF will really need to get to the root of and make sure that they are able to correct all of these things. And you remember what we said, Onye? When things like this happen and the NFF refuse to act, you are laying a precedence for it to happen again. We've had a case a few months ago where the commissioner called his team out of a game in the Federation Cup. Nothing heard about it. And so another commissioner has called his team out, so they say, in the last day, on the last day of the season. The NFF really needs to be on top of this.
So it's quite unfortunate. You know, like our president said here, the gentlemen running these clubs are friends. You know, these are fine gentlemen. Aloy Chukwuemeka has been in football for a long time. Then Mr. Majiko Dumi, the Ogun State FA chairman, also a fine gentleman. You know, and it shouldn't be happening that you walk out, you stage a walkout of it. I think I don't get to hear such stories outside this country. You know, I think the Nigerian Football Federation, you know, we said it here that part of the problem is that there was no standing body to organize the NNL. Look at what they have done with the Nationwide League. You know, Toby was
There's no standing committee for the Nationwide League as well.
But Shola has been involved, has been doing a yeoman's job. You know, you can't say that of NNL.
But they have a fantastic secretary, secretary.
Yeah, but the secretary.
But these things go beyond him because there's nothing
they
can do.
The secretary is probably overwhelmed because the interests are too much. The interests are too much, especially during the business stages of the NLA. Towards the end, the quest to get
the
promotion.
The stakes were so high.
The desperation, you know. So at this level, you must, you know, send the right signals that it's no longer going to be business as usual. If you run foul of the status of football, then you'll be sanctioned. So the Football Federation should investigate. We don't want to be hearing of games being abandoned, staging a walk. It's quite embarrassing. How can you travel from all the way from Ogun State with your supporters and you fail to play the game? You know, I somehow got across to officials of Gateway FC, and they were saying a lot of things, you know, about the game. Purportedly going to be played behind closed doors, and they had to raise sinister motives towards that pre-match meeting. They agreed on 50 policemen. You know, we have shown visuals here who were not there, but Toby Adepoju and President, you know, were there, and he did confirm that there were enough security men.
Gateway had a good chance, Toby. Gateway had a good chance of gaining promotion if they won that game.
Of course.
So were they assuming that a victory wasn't possible for them in that game? But it was a game where everybody had gathered to watch. And if they had gone out there with the intention of winning, who knows?
I mean,
Gombe United won their promotion by beating Kwara United.
I almost mentioned that, Tony. You know, when Gombe came, they also, you know, faced challenges. But they got to the pitch and they got the maximum 3 points. You know, like the president said also, yesterday there was full media coverage. I mean, there was presence of every weight from the federation. There was no way.
But why were they saying that the game should be played behind closed doors? What was the reason why they said?
I heard from source that, you know, ABS management are not really satisfied with the mindset of the Kwara fans, because, you know, some people still felt there was a betrayal between
Kwara United fans. So even to disturb the game,
ABS are even more scared about the indigent base in Kwara, not even the Gateway United fans.
When Gateway fans allowed them to the stadium,
they were allowed to go. They gave them a special place, you know, to be, and then to drum and support their team. And they were just ready to chant for their team. And everyone was expecting the game to go on. I mean, Tony, yes, you know, I really don't know if a team had the right, you know, to demand to play behind closed door. But at the end of the day, the hold was even broken because fans were allowed. At the end of the day, when ABS all, you know, Gateway fans were allowed, they allowed few of their fans. And what they did was, they want to identify everyone that gets into you. You have an accreditation tag, they set you, they make sure they don't want any issues during the game or after the game. But it was so surprising and shocking to see, you know, Gateway decided not to play. I mean, there was no reason for them not to play yesterday, Tony, because we had less than 300, including the journalists and the personality, we had less than 300 people inside the stadium. And for over 50 policemen, is enough to protect everyone inside the stadium.
President, let me come to you now. I mean, as a matter of policy, what should be the way out of this? We don't want this to repeat itself, because our interest on this side is not really to blame someone. Or yes, we give strong words against anybody disrupting the game, bringing it into disrepute, but we must make sure that we put structures in place so that such persons don't have that power anymore. One man just comes and tells the boys, don't play again, and then the whole game is brought to disrepute. So the commissioner in one state will also call his team out. The governor in one state will also call his team out. Then one day, our sports minister will also call the Super Eagles out of a World Cup qualifying game and say, don't play. This is an anomaly.
It's very sad, and sad in the sense that, well, we have a responsibility. I keep telling people that sports has three ways to eat. We have in government, you have executive, legislative, and judiciary. In sports, we have the same. You have the developers, you have the participators, and you have promoters. We have a responsibility. So we are critical stakeholders. We are not spare tires.
Mm.
We are not boys. We are partners in sports development.
Yeah.
And our job is to criticize, suggest positively at any time that things are not going right. And I made a statement. I granted an interview, and I said the commissioner should be well sanctioned.
You insisted that was the commissioner for sports in
Yes, I was there. I saw it 100%. Nobody. In fact, even when the NFF members came back, even when Majek, the FA chairman of Ogun State, came back, we spoke. And we were even there, we were begging. Even when Otumba came, we talked about it. And I said, I suggested that there should be moved to ban him. So that should
But the NFF can't ban him because
there are processes. I spoke to some NFF officials, and they said that there should be arbitration. There should be recommendations from processes to processes, and it will get dovetailed to that level. But we must take a very strong stand, because we don't have any other job but to promote sports. If we allow it at this level, politicize issues of sports, one day, like you said, one day the minister will just come, Nigeria wants to play, and say, Super Eagles, come back.
Or a top government official.
Yes, we know what happens when we refuse to go and defend the Nations Cup. So let us not begin to play back to where. Let's not go back to Egypt. We have left. Let's move forward and do things right.
Let's move towards Canaan.
Yes, let's move towards the promised land. And by doing that, we must sanction anybody that is responsible for any action that we think is wrong. If it were an advanced country, I can't pay money to come and watch match.
And then somebody
come and disturb the match. I'll take him to court.
You take him to court, yes.
So it's just because of the nature, but God will help us one day. We'll move to that level where if you do anything that is wrong, we'll take you to court.
Anyway, to balance things, we will we're throwing this challenge to the Commissioner of Sports in Ogun State. It is important for us to hear from his own side, find out from him what he has to say. Why did he tell the boys not to play? We need to hear from him so that we can balance things. And we're throwing this platform open to the Commissioner for Sports in Ogun State. You can find your way to our studios tomorrow. Let's hear from you why you gave that instruction that Gateway shouldn't play that game against ABS in Ilorin. Guys, I think that settles it. I think that's fair enough.
Yeah.
Let's hear from him and see what reason he will adduce for telling his boys not to play that game. But it's sad, and I don't see how Gateway will get anything from that game. I mean, based on all that we've seen so far, I don't think that game will be replayed. I think that game is gone. I think ABS will get the 3 points, the 3 goals, and they will be back in the Premier
League. I'm not bothered about who became anything, who won,
who
the game
from it, or who didn't gain.
What I'm concerned about is, let us do things right.
Mm. Let's not bring the game to disrepute.
Yeah, of course, that's my concern.
Mm. 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 All right, so that's it. But once again, Commissioner for Sports in Ogun State, we invite you to come and tell us your own side of the story. I hope you can make it here tomorrow, so that we can trash these issues out once and for all. Guys, let's very quickly talk about the Nationwide. Toby, you were there on Saturday. It came to a close, and we'll be talking about this all week.
Yeah.
Fantastic close for the Nationwide League Super 8. And it was Road Safety that won it. FRSC Abuja that won the trophy. You could see the chairman of the league management company. You could see the sponsor and the NFF, represented by Sheyi Akinwumi, presenting the trophy to FRSC. And when we had the best player of the tournament, Steven from Racine, getting his award from Fani Amu as well. And then you had the best goalkeeper, Steven. That's his name as well.
Steven Azubuike. Both Steven won.
Yeah, both Steven won. Yeah, and you can see the chairman of chairman, who is the caretaker chairman of the Nationwide League. And Imama, the man of the moment, presenting the goalkeeper award to the best goalkeeper of the tournament. It was a fantastic tournament, very well organized. at least something to make us happy that the Nationwide League could put such a fantastic show together. So once again, congratulations to the Nationwide League, Seyi, I beg your pardon, Shola, Ogunowo, and his team for what they've been able to put together. All right.